Okay, after the Chabad, Chabad it's shortly Chochma Binadat, it's the acronym, we call it Chabad. We have the sixth attribute of the Vav that correspond to the letter Vav of the name of God, that equals six. This is you
also call it... Also the Rampin is called.
Yes. So we call it Midot. Midot, the attribute of the heart. So, in the book of Chronicles, Chronicles 1, chapter 29, start with verse 10. David is going to bless God. Vayivarech David et Hashem le'enei kol ha'kahal. David bless God to the eyes of all the people. Vayomer David, David say, Baruch ata Hashem, bless you God. The God of Israel, our Father, from the world to the world. Again, from the world to the world is a two hey.
From the world to the world.
Yes. Min ha'olam, avinu me'olam ve'ad olam. You, God, you have lecha Hashem. Now, agdula, in the Zohar, the sphere of chesed called gdula. Based on this verse. All right, so here instead of saying chesed, they call it gdula, righteousness.
This greatness.
Greatness. All right, this corresponds to Abraham. We call Abraham the great one. This has to do with love, chesed.
Like grace?
No. Well,
mercy.
No, this is mercy. No, this is love. This is chesed. It's to give, to give. Somebody that like to give is ish chesed. He like to give to everybody.
Generosity, maybe.
So. Generosity is it's how you call somebody that love to give to give is nadiv, is generous. But we call it. Ish chesed, a person of chesed, he do chasadim, he do favor to everybody, he do good thing to everybody, he help everybody. This what means chesed, correspond to love. Gvura, it's like to be hero, it's like to be hold yourself. Ezu gibor hakoveshet Yisro, the one that he hold is desire. He want to give.
Conquers his desires.
Yeah, he's hero. He hold. Mitgaber al Yitzro.
He conquered. Raise above your inclinations.
Is he want to give too, but it's dangerous to give him. If he give to the not the right person. He will take this advantage from you to do more evil. It's better to not give him. He might think that he's all right. That if I give him, so it means I am good. So I keep doing whatever I want. All right. So this is the opposite. This is the concept of Yitzchak. The fear of Yitzchak, Pachad Yitzchak, like it is written. One of the name of God is Pachad, the fear of Yitzchak. The God of my father Abraham and the fear of Yitzchak, like it is written. Tiferet, it's like the body in the middle. Just like the right hand is the left hand is the body in the middle.
Like beauty or something?
Yeah, before it means it's a beauty of many colors. Because this is one color, this is the other color. Now, if you put all the color together, it means it's connected, the body is connected to everybody around. Alright, so it's like a majesty of many color, of many quality. It's not just one color. This is what makes the beauty. The beauty is not when everything is black, or everything is red, or everything is...
Tiferet is like connected to the area of the heart, sort of?
All this is the heart.
Yeah, but it's like the center of the heart is different.
This like the center of, yeah, you can say that this is the center of the heart, but if we parallel to the body, it's the body. Always parallel. Now, these are two legs. Netzach is a winning. Hod is to accept, to say thank you. It's like a echo head. This is more male, this is more female.
Like winning.
Winning.
Hod is like
loser.
Being
to accept.
Grateful.
To confess, to accept, to say thank you. It's reflection.
Being grateful.
Alright? Yes, so this foundation. Mm-hmm. The foundation of the world. This related to Yosef HaTzadik. This related to Moses. This related to Aharon. This related to Yosef. Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Moshe, Aharon, Yosef. Okay? Mm-hmm. After the last letter of Hashem, is the kingdom, Malchut.
Malchut is underneath.
It's the other letter, the hey, the last letter. All right, so what David say? God, you have... God, you have a greatness, a gdula, it's a chesed.
Greatness.
Lecha Hashem, a gdula, v'agvura, exactly the same word, v'atiferet, v'anetzach, v'ahod. Exactly the same word we use.
That's what David says.
Yes.
Where, can you tell us?
Yeah, I said in Divrei Yamim, chapter 29, verse 10. Kichol b'shamem uva'aretz. Kichol. Ki, because kichol. Kol, it's like everything.
Everything,
yeah. One of the name of the Yesod in Kabbalah is Kol. Kol equals 50. He receives the five chasadim from what is above. It's why we call him Kol. It's like he has everything. Kol. The word mekalkel, kalkala.
Kalkala is economy.
Economy, all right. So this guy that is responsible to bring to everybody food. This is Yosef that give food to everybody. He mekalkel, bringing kalkala, economy to everybody.
Welfare.
All right. So this is a tzaddik, the righteous man.
Welfare.
He gives the food to all the kingdoms that is below. He gives the seed. He realizes the promise, etc. Realization of the promise is here.
Manifestation.
Realization. Alright, to bring the seed to the kingdom. Mm-hmm. This is Yosef HaTzadik. Kikol, the way it is written, Kikol, Kikol, because Kol, Bashamayim uva'aretz, is...
Because everything.
He makes the connection between heaven and earth. Ki kol b'shamayim uva'aretz. It means you have the kol that is in heaven and in earth. It makes the connection between both of them.
Yes, so
this is like heaven. This is like below the malchut. It's like earth. It makes the connection. Ki kol b'shamayim uva'aretz. All right, this is the concept of the tzaddik. Yesod olam. Why is the foundation of the world? Because it's like a pillar that makes connection between...
A pillar
that what make a connection between what is above and what is below.
The mouth below.
Kikol equal Yesod, 80. All right, it's the same gematria. It's not the same word, but it's the same gematria.
Interesting.
Kikol equal Yesod.
So David, Melech David, King David knew exactly what he was talking about.
Yes. Kikol is Yesod. And he continued, Lacha Hashem, Amamlacha. Mamlacha, it's another form for Malchut, what it means, kingdom. You, God, you have the kingdom, etc. Alright, so this where appear the attribute of the heart of the ten sefirot in the Bible. Alright, so it's all biblical. All the Kabbalah is written in the Bible. Before we talk about the mental, now we talk about the attribute of the heart.
So people should not be afraid of the wisdom of Kabbalah.
People
the
should
of
not
Kabbalah.
Be afraid of learning Torah.
People are afraid of oral Torah, some people. I mean.
People don't have to be afraid of learn anything.
Yeah.
It's not witchcraft or whatever. It's Torah learning, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So learning Torah, it's important, it's the most important thing. It's the redemption. What we'll have in the redemption that we don't have now? Only one thing. Everybody in the world will learn Torah. It's all. All the redemption is to get to a state that we will have all the time in the world to learn Torah. This is redemption, it's not anything else. To be able to learn Torah in this world, this is all the redemption. All the world will learn Torah, not only the Jew. All the Goyim will learn Torah.
The nations.
All the, everybody, Umal Aretz, Deit Hashem, the land will be full, the knowledge of God, like the sea cover the ocean. Alright, so to learn is something good, it's not something to be afraid of it.
I think even Yeshua was saying that we should
and we can,
research everything and choose what is
and
good.
And we cannot understand anything that it is written in the New Testament if we don't know Kabbalah. All the explanation of what Jesus said in the connection, in the place, in the situation, why he said this after this, if we don't know Kabbalah, we don't understand why he says so in this place after this thing, in this special world, we cannot understand it.
See?
The book of Revelation is a book of Kabbalah. It's 100% Kabbalah. We cannot understand the book of Revelation if we don't know Kabbalah. Alright? If we learn Torah like a book of instruction, how to eat, and how
like
to...
cooking book.
Like a cooking book. Right? This is, you cannot eat this, you have to eat this, and this is not kosher, and this is kosher. We have to learn Torah this way too. It's important to know what Torah tells us practically to do. But this is the most low level of understanding the Torah.
So you're talking about the Pardes, Pshat,
above
and
this,
or...
Above this, we have to understand the why, the wisdom that hiding in this letter, in this thing that God said. Right? So it's not enough to learn Torah, just to learn how to be a good person and to learn how to act. This is just the most basic level.
So
this is just the frame of the picture of God, the frame. It's a frame that he keep us there, right? We cannot pass, go over this frame, but we must to put...
There are more dimensions inside.
We must to have inside this frame the picture of God. And if we don't have the picture of God, we have only the frame. This is good, this is bad. We don't have nothing.
Can you say two words about Pardes? That the level of the Torah? Or you don't want to get
it? Well, it is...
You're talking about those levels now.
The Pardes, it's like paradise.
Paradise.
But Pardes, it means a place where growing trees or fruits.
Orchard in English.
But what it means, a Pardes, when we say Pardes in Kabbalah, we talk about the acronym to go to the Pardes, it means to go to heaven, but it's meant to learn Torah in the four dimension
levels
of understanding.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Pshat. Pshat, it's a, literally what it means, it's a Remez, the Int, it's a Midrash, and it's a Soy.
Drash.
Is a midrash?
Pardes.
Pardes.
Drash.
I'm sorry.
Drash.
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 Drash,
and Sod.
And Sod.
Sod is the level of Kabbalah, the wisdom of Kabbalah.
Yeah.
The deepest level.
Remez is the int. All the Gimetiot, all the int of the Gimetiot are in the Remez. After another way, after we know the true, I want to tell you the true in a way that only with a story. Alright? A story, it can be completely imaginary story. One time I walk and I saw a big mountain and a big scorpion, like a big mountain, etc. And it did so and so. All kind of story, imaginary story. This is called drash. It's like to tell you something deep in full story. Mm-hmm. After is a secret. The secret, it's like
Sod is a
it's
secret.
Like to touch the completely the name of God,
the structure of the reality.
Okay.
And pshat is the first one is the simple pashut.
Yes.
So you think that Yeshua, Jesus...
Pshat is tipesh. Tipesh is stupid, is the same letter.
Yeah. Simple.
Tipesh is stupid.
Uh-huh.
Well, somebody that thinks that we have to learn only the pshat is a stupid.
So you think Jesus, Yeshua knew Kabbalah?
Of course.
Like all the wise men in the Bible.
He was a prophet. A prophet, it means he don't know, he experienced it. He lived it.
I mean, Kabbalists were people that reached godliness, actually, that had an understanding of the creation. Is this correct?
What?
Mekubalim, Kabbalists, people that wrote wisdom books about the wisdom of Kabbalah, they were people that reached godliness. They were very, very high level of understanding and experiencing the
It can be that they are only wise people. Sometimes it is written Chacham Adif Minavi. A wise is better, it's more adif, it's not mean that is more
preferred
of a prophet, because with wisdom you can imagine what is very high, and you can with your understanding get much more high of a prophet in the place that he see, he experience. Right, because a prophet can, somebody can be a prophet only in Olam Asiya,
which is quite low. It's our world.
I wish I was a prophet of Olam Asiya. All right, a prophet of Olam Asiya, it means I see the angel of Olam Asiya, of the lowest world. But still, to experience it, Olam Asiya in holiness, it's something very great, and it is a prophet that arrived to Olam HaYetzirah, it's a prophet that arrived to Olam HaBriah. Nobody really arrived to Olam HaAtzilut. Maybe Moses arrived to the legs of Olam HaAtzilut. Right? Maximum.
And Jesus, Yeshua, he came from above. Actually, he's very high.
All right, so
Yechida.
He experienced whatever he experienced. Alright? He don't understand what he experienced. It's not always understand it. A chacham, it's like something more practical. He can understand what is way, way, way above, even he was never there. He didn't achieve this level. Alright? So everything I teach is based on wisdom. It's not based on experience. I cannot tell you I was there and I saw so, and I was there and I saw so. No me. All right? We can add a nice gematria about Kabbalah. That Kabbalah equal
137
equal 137, what is a very important number in science.
Mm-hmm.
But what we're talking about right now is Chokhmah plus Nevuah. Has that on of Chen. Chokhmah, wisdom, plus prophecy. It means Kabbalah is not only prophecy, is not only wisdom, is both together. It means the wisdom of the prophecy, the wisdom that is behind the prophecy. Right, so I have the same gematria. Chokhmah plus Nevuah has the acronym of Chen. Chen is what we call is the acronym of Chokhmah Nistara. How we call it? Another name for Kabbalah is Chokhmah Nistara.
The hidden wisdom.
People that know the wisdom of Kabbalah, we call them Yodei Chen. They know. People that know Chen. It means they know Chokhmah Nistara. We said it in Ikonim. We call Chen, all the wisdom of Kabbalah, we call it Chen. Alright, so.
Sounds like the Chen that you're talking about in your book.
So all.
The grace.
All what I talk about is Chen, what it means, hiding. Wisdom, what it's mean
hidden
Kabbalah.
Wisdom.
The wisdom,
hidden wisdom.
It's called Chen. Leyod Chen. This is the expression, many times we'll find this expression, especially for Yod Chen, especially for people that know Kabbalah. For the Mekubalim. You add. Things that not everybody will understand. Yeah. Only Yod Chen will understand
because it. Because Mekubalim are people that attain a certain level in spirituality.
I don't talk about level of spirituality. Okay. I talk about, they know what we talk about. Okay. It's not have to be with a spiritual level. Spiritual level have to do with prophecy. Not understanding of the wisdom have to do with wisdom. Each one have advantage.
Advantage over the other.
It's two different things.
Okay.
You know, sometimes installator is more practical of a technician, of engineer of electricity. If I want,
you have a leak in your house, then it's more important.
All right. For what I need, I don't need the engineer of water. Okay. I need, somebody to fix something and some, right? So it's not mean that one is higher or is better of the other one in the sense, regular sense of is better.
No, I was just making a definition.
It can be, a chacham can be more practical, sense of better as practical of a prophet. Because a prophet, he experienced what he experienced, have a dream. All right, so he tell you, I saw so and so and so. Maybe he don't understand anything what he saw, what he experienced. Like Daniel, they tell him all kind of thing. They show him all kind of thing, and he say, I don't understand. All right, so the angel tell him, all right, you go to sleep. When you wake up in the end of the day. You will understand whatever had to be understand.
Understood.
All right? The Chachamim will understand. All right, so Kabbalah 137 equal wisdom 73 plus Nevoah. How much equal Nevoah? 61, 64. No. Yes. All right.
Yes.